I do a life history program, and the primary thing is to recognize the manatees year after year. You do that by identifying the scars that they have from the boats. We have fingerprints, they have scar patterns. Once the research is done here, I report it up to the Sirenia Project up in Gainesville, which is a federal group, and of course they're looking at manatees all over Florida into the Caribbean, not just here at Blue Spring. Okay, so Kathy, I brought my pictures up so
you can
get the new pictures into the database. I think we're looking at Blue Spring 4 Lily here.
Oh, she's an old one.
And if you can go from that, I know we've had Lily around since, well, she was at Blue Spring before I was. And
Let's see.
So that's close to 40 years ago. And she was there before that.
We know she was there at least since 1978.
She was thought to be a young matron. And soon after that, she had her first calf, and she had several calves as the years went by. Right now, she's still coming in. She's awful beat up, and she's in the adoption program with Save Manatee Club, and we've been seeing her every year ever since I've been here. I even keep track of genealogies, and of course, it has to go through the female. And we even have at least one that's gone to seven generations.
Wayne's contribution is amazing to this database. He matches the animals, we verify the matches, and they get entered into the MIPS database, the Manatee Individual Photoidentification System. And that's a statewide database that includes over 4,600 manatees that are known statewide. And we have a sighting history for each of those individuals, and some of them go back 30, 40 years. Some even longer than that, and from that we're able to look at the habitat use, the sighting history, the reproductive history of those individuals, and look at their movements, where they're going, how often they come in, and from that then determine, be able to estimate reproduction and survival, annual survival of those individuals.
It's always a lot of fun when they manage to match some of the animals that come in here to animals they've seen elsewhere. You might get an animal that's come 700 or more miles just to come into Blue Spring.
So we're seeing new animals for Wayne that are coming in to Blue Spring that we've identified, you know, in previous years from the east coast of Florida.
Sometimes, like Millie, she comes in, I take pictures of her, turns out she's been photographed for 12 years all up and down the East Coast before she ever came to Blue Spring. And even now, she'll leave Blue Spring for years and then show up again, and we'll get reports of her being in Port Everglades or maybe even just up the river, and she didn't bother to come down to Blue Spring.
Millie's first sighting was in 1980 in Titusville. And her first calf that we know of was in January of 1985. She was seen with a calf. She's had 10 calves that we know of. So she pretty much travels the East Coast.
When I see three notch, like the first year I'm at Blue Spring, and in the next 15 years, I see him two more times, 8 years later and then 7 years later. Three notch is one of those animals that was here shortly after I came. So after many years, all at once, Three Notch turns up in 2017 in the summer. And we wouldn't even have known he was here except he was caught on the webcam, the Save Manatee Club's webcam. It wasn't too long after that, unfortunately, that he was found dead in the Miami River, a long way from here.
This was the webcam photo in August of 17.
And between my first sighting and 15 years later, he hardly changed at all. But then in this picture here, he is all beat up.
He is. And he'd been on the East Coast for... I'm looking to see. He was in Jacksonville in 95, but he hadn't been at Blue Spring that we know of since 93. Yeah, he spent most of his time around Miami, it looks like, that we know of. But he did. He had a lot of new scars since he'd been back. But he had a lot of documentation on the East Coast, you know, during those years.
Yeah. The manatee camel was a big female who turned up here 1 year, and very well marked, very interesting animal, and it was soon found that she was also from down south in the Miami area.
She was first identified as a female with a calf, so she was an adult in 1998. again, all along the East Coast.
I've been doing the manatee research here at Blue Spring for 38 years now. I enjoy it.
How many decades has it been that you've been doing this?
Almost
three,
four.
Okay. So there are several thousand sightings in here, of course, at least,
yep,
that you've contributed to this database. And because of that effort, especially at Blue Spring, which is better covered than any other site in the state, we have a really good sense of what's going on with that group, that population that overwinters there.